So you're here for your routine eye examination. No problems with your vision. Distance and near. It's okay with your spectacles. Good. Good. No headache. Double vision. Excellent. And your health is tipped up. Do you take any medication? No. Are there any eye problems in the family? Any family history of eye problems? No family. Start with the examination. I think we'll start with a vision test. With this chart here. Yep. Now I just want you to cover your left eye. Just cover your left eye like so. But don't apply too much pressure to the orbit. Far down as on the chart as you can. Excellent. Keep going. Fantastic. Just cover your right eye now with the palm of your hand. Read down on the chart as far as you can, please. Excellent. Just record the unaided vision now. Right eye. For the cover test. Now, if you may, just looking at the H above my finger. And I'm just covering one eye at a time here. Just change your focus to the letter T, please. And the occluder will just swing from right to left. Just follow the letter for me, please. Excellent. Test. Just follow the T as closely as you can towards your nose and let me know if you experience any double vision. And once more for me. A measurement convergence distance there using this ruler. Convergence to 3 centimeters. Okay, now I'm just going to check your pupil reactions to the light with this simple flashlight. Just looking at the wall behind me now. swinging flashlight test now. From right to left. Just keep looking straight. Pupil sizes look equal between the two eyes. There is now obvious anisocoria. I do not see anisocoria. Fantastic. Okay, and I'm just going to check your pupillary distance now. Into my right eye, the ruler will just rest against your forehead. Now looking into the left, back to the right, and the left. So we're looking at distance PD of 65 millimeters, and a near PD measurement now. At the H for me, please. Keep looking at the H. I'll check that distance of 64 millimeters. Stick. Now we're going to have an external look at the eyes. Require my strong magnification lenses because I will be coming a little bit closer to observe the ocular features. Oh yes, I have some extra magnification there. Just look straight ahead for me, please. Observe the lids and lashes of the right eye. Good. Take a blink. Okay, let's have a look under the lid, just looking up for me. And I'll just have a grouse look at the lacrimal system. Do you suffer with dry eyes at all? Any grittiness, soreness, or epiphora? Any epiphora? Straight ahead for me now. Take a blink. Looking up again. Observe the inferior cornea, the puncta, the lashes. So now trichiasis is just looking down to the floor now. So I can raise the lid. Superior conjunctiva. No obvious hyperemia there. Keep looking down now. Fantastic. And I think we're going to need some extra magnification to observe the puncta and the lacrimal system in more detail. So I'm just going to introduce this magnification device. It's an old style magnifier, very large, so we have a good field of view with decent amount of magnification there. So the lower puncta appears open, which is good, and the upper puncta and the superior lid. Good. I just want to apply a little bit of pressure on the lower lid here. It won't hurt. Just a slight bit of pressure there. Good. And I'm just going to pull the lid down and release it quickly. And again, this is called a snap. Good response and recovery from the long leg. Okay. Pull the loaded down again and release once more. We have a very good snap back there. Let's just observe the lower punctor. Excellent. Now trichiasis. And now epiphora or hyperemia. Grade 1 redness. The conjunctiva right and left. Ophthalmoscopy. So we're just going to dim the room lights. My illumination device here. Just bear with me one moment. Rather old thermoscope. With a brightness setting here, we have the filter setting here with four filters and a focusing wheel, a little lens cap. Okay, and an aperture wheel. Okay. Just looking straight ahead as I come a little bit closer. And he's going beyond the crystalline lens now. Switch apertures now. I'm going to continue with the white light. And we'll check the macula and fovea area. This is your central vision. Down to the floor now. I'll raise the lid for optimum viewing of the fundus. And for the left eye, keep looking straight ahead. Dim the light. I just want you to look directly at the light for me so I can observe the macula. Very good. I take a blink. Now looking up to the ceiling. Your right hand side, and looking left, and just looking inferior retina there. Inferior retina. Good. And I'm just going to focus on the blood vessels with the red free filter. It's looking straight for me. And a nice 3 to 4 AV ratio. Nipping or tortuosity. Tortuosity is absent. Good. And for the left, looking straight. Okay, so the blood vessels look fine. The pulse eyes using the red free filter. Excellent. Okay. So, ocular health looks fine. We are going to now perform a retinoscopy. So, I just find my retinoscope. My retinoscope with a condensing filter there, with the light coming through the top, and we have a wheel here for the brightness intensity. So we're going to perform this test on a bright light setting. So let me just select a lens from the trial lens set. +150 lens. Just look straight at the wall for me now, please. And I'm just going to sweep the light to neutralize the movement there. Okay. And we have a +250 diopter sphere next. Keep looking straight. Results from the right eye. Right eye +050 diopter sphere. And we'll move on to the left eye now, starting with the +150 lens. Keep looking straight ahead. Excellent. And the +250 diopter sphere. Doesn't seem to be any obvious astigmatism, just a spherical looking prescription. But let me just reduce this lens power. and the plus two. Plus two. Excellent. So similar to the right eye, the left you have a plus 50 dioptosphere retinoscopy result. Just going to do a subjective refraction now, a very brief subjective refraction. So we're just going to turn the room lights back up now. Okay, so I just want you to cover your left eye for a moment. Present some lenses to you. Okay, so in front of the first eye, do I look clearer with the lens or without? That's with, and that's without. With. Just going for the plus one now. Do I look clearer with the lens or without? This is with. Without. Without. And just the plus 75 dioptosphere. Am I clearer with the lens or without? Okay, plus our 50 result there. Just cover your other eye for me now, please. And let's present the plus our 50 lens. Do I look clearer with the lens? Without? Or about the same? This is with again. And this is without. Lovely. Plus 75 now. With or clearer without. This is with and this is without. You feel without. Fantastic. Okay, so the subjective result is what we had with retinoscopy. Diaptosphere, right and left. Stunts. And I'm just going to do a brief near vision test now. Just cover your left eye for me again, please. And just read the rows of letters on the chart as far as you can. And the bottom block. Is this possible? Cover the other eye for me now, please. And just read out as far as you can. And N6. Fantastic. And another near vision test. Let's see if you can read some of the print here for me, please. And here. And what about this very fine print are you able to read this very fine print? And last part. Just try reading some of this data. Stick. And we have one final test. Okay, I'm just going to ask you what you can identify on these pictures, please. Excellent. Okay. And what do you observe here? And here? And there? And finally here. Just record those results, but I'm pleased to say everything is looking fine following this eye examination. It was signed for, and I will print off a copy of your prescription to take away with you. Next examination will be in 2 years' time. And I hope you enjoyed yourself. I will see you very soon.